Hey, we are back with a little more Mike Plays Panzer Corps 2. We're moving on to a second Netherlands scenario. Events in the Netherlands are moving quickly, my general, so I'd best be quick with your briefing today. Dutch counterattacks have put some of our forces back, and they are attempting to reform their defenses here at the Grebline. Our task is to resume the offensive and prevent the Dutch from creating a redoubt around central Holland at Katsalis until help arrives from either Britain or France. Primary objective, capture 4 victory hexes. Bonus objective, capture Utrecht a full turn before the last victory hex. The terrain of the region is extremely dense, so once again I recommend leaving behind most, if not all, our panzer forces. Without the element of surprise, our armored Fallschirmjägers probably won't be very effective, but their special explosives will still work against enemy strong points on the Grebby line. I would recommend employing our pioneer infantry in this battle as they are. There are some reports of minefields in the region with the vital virtual annihilation of the Dutch Air Force. Any resistance from enemy aircraft will likely be minimal. Our own aircraft will definitely serve us well in rooting out the enemy from their defensive positions. As before, the Dutch possess very little in the way of vehicles or armor, so extra artillery and only a few anti-tank weapons would also serve us well. One more thing, watch for this hilltop position. Substantial artillery units have been spotted setting up on the high ground. Victory for Germany. Okay. All right, we'll be right back and set the order of battle. Okay, we are back to set the order of battle. First thing, of course, is, as always, to issue replacements to everybody. I'm a little overpowered here. I'm gonna clear some slots for action. But I got a lot of infantry, a lot of artillery, a few tanks. First thing is I need to get this KV-2 bunker buster out there. So I'm going to drive my main bunker buster. My main thrust is going to be right down here across this river. Because what I want to do is get up in here, fight my way through these defenses, and get to this hill 14 where they've got their artillery. And then we can capture Utrecht. As a primary objective. So I'm going to put the KV-2 first. I'm going to put the SDKFZ Rad. As my scout car, I'm going to put my S-Bridger here. Bridger up there. I might as well give him one. Okay. Then my city busting troops are going to be my Azules. Can I upgrade them to a half track? No. Still can't. They're going to be there. My best pioneers. And I'm going to give them the no retaliation here. Here's my Scharfschütze and my Grenadiers. Okay, so this battle group is going to be the ones fighting the main thrust. They have everything. Elsa Kloss, Sarah Slotzer, two slots. If I put Elsa Kloss there. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to drop the reduced slots hero, and I'm going to assign, where's Elsa? So I have like one absolute stud artillery unit. Where is she? Can I not group them together? There she is. So, I've got artillery support, AT support, lethal attack. Okay, this is the best artillery unit I have. I'm going to team them up with my Werframen. And then in terms of other panzers, I've got an F and a G. I'm going to pair a G here. This F, I think I can, let's see if there's any. Yeah, I've got H's now, also experimental. That's going to go up here. Along with a big artillery piece there. A small artillery piece. Cycle recon. It's Panzer II. Let me see. What other Panzer IIs do I have? Panzers do I have? Command Panzer. I have two Panzer Ones. Can I upgrade my anti-tank? Yes, I want to upgrade to a Panzer Jaeger. Onto the battlefield here to take on tanks. And my 88 anti-aircraft gun is going to go with this group here. Whoops, no, I didn't mean to do that. 88. So, these guys are going to get 10 and a Stuka. It's HE-111. Do I need him in this campaign? Move him to reserve. And I'm going to swap out another fighter. This guy. So I have two fighters. Undeployed. Infantry. Well, I'm going to need some pioneers, it said. So I'm going to put a pioneer there. Back in reserve, and I'm going to pull this command tank out of reserve. Because those are very useful. pioneers. I'll set a few up here. Got a sharp shoots in. I do have 3 Fallschirmjägers. Set them up there. Now, what will they do? Now, they're going to help me first take Renan and the airfield around it. That Fallschirmjäger is going to go into reserve. And that means... Put him there, he'll fall hopelessly behind. Oh well. And do I need this artillery there, along with a couple more infantry? And that's it. Now, I can take a Panzer 1. Put another anti-tank gun out on the field. There's hardly any tanks. What's this guy's experience? 177. 128. I'll put this other Panzer 1 out here. Okay, now I'm going to buy a couple Kubel wagons, because I think here and one here. Okay. They're cannon fodder. Alright, we're ready to go. No, we're not doing that. Kubelwagen. Here's a pioneer. Take out those mines. Three piece, hit that tank. Answer 3H. So him. Take that town. Get my cavalry out there. Yeah, that's what I thought. Motorcycle infantry on that anti-tank gun and retreat for defensive purposes. Scharfe shoots in. You're going to advance carefully, as are my infantry and my pioneers. Stuka that armored car. And BF-110C, this artillery base. Almost got him. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to change the camo on these two squadrons so that they're more distinctive. I can easily see them better. Better, that's kind of a winter. change all the colors here to winter camo. That way this squadron is more easily distinguished from the other squadron. Okay. I'm going to send my new Panzerjäger, my first self-propelled gun. I'm going to send him forward. And I'm going to turn him to an anti-tank mode. And I'm going to fire upon him and destroy him. Alright, that means this artillery piece needs to come up here for support. Here's forward. Move my Wehrmacht infantry forward. Okay, good. So this is sort of the central group here. Alright. I'm going to hit that artillery first. Artillery on artillery fire there. See if my Sturmovik can take him out. No. Still not up to his first combat star. You know what? I could sneak my car back in there. My pioneers, I'm going to come. Fields. My command tank down here, take this town. Use my Azul infantry to take out a minefield. Ooh, not quite. Use my sharpshoots in there. Okay, I'm gonna hit him with my rocket launchers. And my grenadiers. Gonna use my KV-2. And my Panzer 3. Come down here and take Renan. I'm going to scout this area with my Storch. Actually, first of all, let me fly over that Hulk and get it off the field. I hate the burning Hulks. It's an OCD thing. Okay, good. This will be easy. Here. Here and here. We're in good shape there. Stuka these guys. And attack them with my inexperienced Panzer 1. Ah, shit. I should have done it the other way. Okay. Kubel wagon. Aircraft gun, just in case there's any planes around. Okay, I'm going to use my fighter squadron to protect those two bombers. And I'm going to use my DO-217. Bomb this anti-aircraft gun. I expected there to be more bunkers here. There might be some bunkers hidden, but I expected more bunkers. And my BF-110C, I may as well swing him up here, make him useful against those guys. Okay, so my two-pronged, really it's a three-pronged attack. I have these tank hunter right here. Off to a good start. I could come up here and attack them. That's going to make them really vulnerable to infantry counterattack on a bridge without any artillery support, and I'm not going to do that because that unit is too valuable. Oh yeah, see, they do have some planes. So weak as we were led to believe. Yeah, they have fighters. Stinking Dutchman. He's going to come forward, trying to engage my infantry. Shoot at my planes. Bring their anti-tank guns forward. Okay, first things first. Fighter squadron, where are you? There you are. You to attack these guys right here. Fallschirmjägers, we need to take this air base. I want you to attack this airfield, this anti-aircraft gun. I want my command tank to come down the road here. Marching. Now I'm going to use my KV-2 captured Soviet tank. Bring up my Werframen. Yeah, I got my tanks across the river. I'm going to shell that infantry. And I'm going to move my armor there. I can relaunch my best pioneers forward. Shoots it forward. Okay. These pioneers need to get up this way. The Oswalds need to get this way. Luckily, I have fast deployment on this 88, so I can shoot at this plane. Down he goes. Down goes Frasier. Okay, my Stuka is going to be a lot more effective right here. Get after that any tank gun, swing around and take the town of Village. Take out the anti-tank gun. Move my Wehrmacht forward. Move fires forward to take out those minefields. This minefield we can just bypass. Okay. What do we do here? What do we do? What do we do? I think we move our planes forward to this forward airfield. I start scout plane. Okay. My other fighter squadron. I'm going to go after this fighter plane. Take him out. That artillery piece forward. Sharp shoots him forward. My Wehrmacht infantry forward. Move my cavalry forward to take out that anti-tank gun. Hit you with a little anti- Kubel wagon forward. Move my motorcycle recon forward. Move my Panzer III forward. Move my big artillery piece forward. Move my little artillery piece forward. Move my bridgers forward. Move my pioneers forward. And lastly, my put them right there. All right, next turn, I'll be able to move my light fighters and bombers to this airfield. As it turns out now, I got a Ju-88 I can use against that anti-aircraft gun, and then fly over hill. A little preview of hill. Stuka, Aracon, and then I have the BF-110C. Which I'll just use on these troops here. To no effect. I'm going to use my self-propelled Panzerjäger. I think that's it. Move my Kubel wagon. Kubel wagons don't do very well through forested areas. Alright, that's it. That's turn two. Let's see what the Dutch do in return. They're going to shoot at my plane. It's really just using him as a scout anyway. Okay. Let's use my motorcycle to move forward. Send my bridgers down to attack that anti-tank unit. Use my scout car. Infantry I'm going to use to my pioneers I'm going to use to get rid of these minefields. trucks, artillery here. And then force march my sharpshooters forward. These Wehrmachts come my cavalry if I push them. Yeah, the cavalry can take that airfield. Which is cool, because then I can rebase smaller aircraft there. My Stuka. My BF-110 can go there. And my JU-88 can go there too after we reinforce it. Panzer 3, move him forward. Here's 8 wagon. That's it, right? So the northern tier of attack is going well. These are like inexperienced pioneers. Let's get rid of those minefields. Just to get rid of them. Okay, so are we going to, this is my main one with Elsa Kloss and Siegfried von Bond. My pioneers in here. Wipe out those fucks. I'll come over and take that victory hex. And my Scharfe shoots in. My command tank and my bridger. Okay. Now things get messier because there's so much good air cover here. See what I'm facing. Oh, a couple of tanks. Alright. So I think next turn I'm going to reinforce this KV-2. Rebase my Stuka. Rebase my fighter if I can. I can. These guys, I'm going to have to wait for them to come away from those anti-aircraft guns. Let's see if I can get anything out in the open here. I can. Okay, these guys are all well protected. So I expect the tank counterattack to come through here. Ideally, I'd like to get my Panzerjäger along here with my Panzer 3 and my 88 to fight those tanks. But I gotta clear some space out here. Reinforce that Kubel wagon. Oh, and I do have a big heavy bomber, but if I attack that, there's gonna be more anti-aircraft fire there, so I'll just go here. Infantry. Yeah, see, I took a hit. took some losses. Next turn, we are going to... Well, you know what we're going to do? We're going to fly this sucker here. We're going to steal this airbase behind enemy lines. Because here's what we want to do. We want to break with our Panzerjäger and our Panzer III and maybe our Wurfrahmen. And maybe our 88. We want to break through here, avoiding this hill 17 and take Utrecht first. Back and attack hill 14. It's going to take some doing because the enemy will surely guess our move. All right, let's see what they do. Yeah, they're going to bring me. I'm going to bring the artillery out. They're going to make this difficult. Attack my Panzer 1. That hurt. Attack my Kubel wagon. That's what I want you to do. Okay. Guys here, these Fallschirmjägers. Here, take this airfield. First things first, shell that sucker there. Take out this minefield. Move these pioneers here. Send my Scharfschützen in up there. Use my Sturmovik. Wipe him out. Good. Okay, got that guy there. I'm gonna move my Azules that way. I'm gonna slip my Panzerjäger in behind him, actually. Just trying to lure these two guys away from the protection of those anti-aircraft guns. Stuka these guys. Stuka. Hmm. let's think about how best to do this. What I need to do is attack that anti-tank gun with infantry, but it's hard to do that. My infantry is so far behind. I can use my armored car. Sharp shoots him forward. I can use my heavy strategic. Stuka. Followed by my cool wagon. Okay, I've got Wehrmacht infantry here. I've got Wehrmacht infantry here. I've got pioneers. I've got light artillery. Cycle recon. I've got pioneers. I've got a Kubel wagon to take a little heat. Okay, that's about the best I can do now. My BF-110C. Again, I'll get into fire here, counter battery fire. I'm just going to take it. Attack that anti-aircraft gun and my fighter plane. Attack this artillery base. And I got my Panzer III. Take out that anti-aircraft gun. Or that anti-tank gun. I can never get them right, can I? Kubel wagon will take the town of Village. Gotta be careful about that Panzer III. Make sure I don't lose it. Alright. Let's see what they do. Let's see if these tanks come out. But I gotta draw them out into an open battle. That's the idea where I can use my Air Force to hit them. And they're gonna fire some artillery at me. Some artillery forward where it's exposed. It's kind of foolish. Is there fortresses to go after my command tank? Go after my Kubel wagon. Ooh, destroyed my Kubel wagon. Well, that's what Kubel wagons are. Yeah, here they go. Attack my command tank. Okay, now I was hoping to reinforce my KV-2, but I may not be able to. I may have to use them. Where's my two is going to hit that anti-aircraft gun. Stuka is going to hit this tank. JU-88 is going to hit that anti-aircraft gun. And my Sturmovik, which still doesn't have his first. Yeah, he's got his experience for a star. He's gonna hit that. Use my puzzles. Take that town. About that fortress. Okay. That means I can get my tank into the battle there. Get my Wehrmachts going. Turn my 88 into an anti-tank mode. Get him across the river. Very well coordinated. This cool wagon back there. Sharfa shoots it into the act. Drop my paratroopers here. Yeah, I haven't moved anybody forward on that yet, but here we go. Fighter plane. Gonna move the storch forward. Okay. These people over in my Telegram chat, they just keep. They just keep posting. It keeps showing up. Shows up on the radio. It's irritating as fuck. Okay. Panzer 1. I'm gonna go full reinforcement on that. Okay. Stuka, these artillery pieces. Ten that artillery piece. I'm gonna use my fighter on that artillery piece. I'm gonna use my heavy bomber on these guys. Will be next. Okay, I'm going to change this 88 to not anti-tank mode, but to artillery mode. And I'm going to use my armored car to take it out. Sharf shoots in, going to advance. Wehrmacht infantry. Get my artillery moving forward. Get these fucking fucks here. 3. Motorcycle recon. Pioneer. Bridgers. Cavalry. Okay, so I'm on the brink of wiping them off of this side of the Eam River. Scout. May as well overstrengthen them. He's way back here. Do I have any trains? Okay, we'll just stand pat where we are and let the Dutch try to counterattack right into my 88. That's not very smart. Little counter battery fire there. It's gotta hurt. Well, I can see that it's not going to be easy to approach Utrecht from the south. Going after my Fallschirmjäger is pretty good. Okay, 52nd Fallschirmjäger is a survivor. Alright, we're going to move our Panzerjäger forward to try to take out this armored car. And use our 88 to finish him off. Actually, we want to move him forward here. Finish him off. Man tank forward. Use our Fallschirmjägers to take out the anti-aircraft guns. This is my bunker buster. I'm going to reinforce him and move my Panzer III down the line. There's a considerable force there. After those guys, gonna move my bombers forward. Light bombers. Remember, Utrecht is the main emphasis of this attack. Dirt airfield, light bombers. Fighter. See if I can expose that. And my heavy bomber. Let's see if I can take out this anti-aircraft gun. Thereby making Utrecht. Yep. Thereby making Utrecht more exposed. Actually, let's get the bridges up that way. Okay. This airfield. Move my scout plane or my fighter jet there, and then I'm going to move my heavy bomber there also. And when I do, it will come right over this guy. Force march him over. This Wehrmacht guy over. Take care of that. Use my light artillery. Finish him off. Reinforce my Panzer 3H. Reinforce my motorcycle infantry. And then start positioning my forces. Here's my pioneers. Where's my other pioneers? They're right there. My firebox. My other pioneers. My Scharfschützens. My cavalry. Into an anti-tank mode. And I'm gonna put them right up here. For use against that fortress, along with my pioneers. My Panzer I's gonna streak through here. And that does my Stuka. Ooh, that was a big one. Expected to get a one kill, got three kills. Pretty epic. My Scharfschützen are going to move back into a better position. And this completely unnecessary coup. Okay, that's it. That's the end of the turn. The anti-aircraft. Down off the hill. Send the artillery out. Use their fortress to attack my KV-2. Use their troops to attack my pioneers. Use their troops to attack my Panzer. Use their troops to attack my pioneers again. Damn. Okay, thank God those were my best pioneers. These are my best pioneers. Okay, best pioneers. Gonna come up here and hit this. Armor? Artillery. I'm gonna take hill. I've taken hill 14. Artillery up there. My bridger's over here. All right. Heavy bomber. Actually, I'm going to use these Fallschirmjägers to go attack this artillery that's been harassing me so much. These Fallschirmjägers to attack those troops. Get these guys up to attack that artillery piece. Warfrauen. My Panzer 3. Use my Stuka. And use my Sturmovik. I don't even know what the strength of this is. It's not showing. Is it 10 or 15? Yeah, strong point. It's a 20. Oh, that's going to be huge. Okay. Very difficult to take out. Reinforce those anti-tank weapons. Let's cool away. Down here. Okay, so since this is a 20, which is not some, there's some little defect in the game where it doesn't show the numbers. Like this shows the strength number is 10. Okay, 10, 10 out of 10 here. It's 19 out of 20. It's going to take quite a bit of beating down to take Utrecht. So it's just the way it's going to go. Wehrmacht infantry. Those experienced Wehrmachts. Concentrate all my artillery fire set troops and take them out. Sharpshoots in over here, my special sharpshooters. Send my motorcycle infantry in to finish those guys off. They're finished. My Panzer over here. Bomber. Enter one across the river. Stuka. Now, according to this, I have to take Utrecht first before I take the main victory hexes. So, fair enough. Fighter plane. I'll just do a little harassing attack on these Dutch troops here. One more experience for my BF-110. Attack that enemy aircraft unit. That's about it. I'm gonna pause before I go to the next turn and get some more Dr. Pepper. Sorry, I hit the next turn button before I hit the record button. So they're attacking us. They're gonna attack my Fallschirmjägers. My tank across the bridge. Not a good move for them. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take these paratroopers. Instead of focusing on Utrecht, I'm gonna come over here and take this airfield from behind. I'm gonna do the same thing with these Fallschirmjägers. First things first. Where's my nearest heavy strategic It's not it. There it is, JU-88. Okay, I'm gonna bomb that. That artillery piece. Stuka this fortress. Further bomb. strafe attack with my BF-110C, that artillery piece, and I'm going to try to... here. My 88. Take it out. Then I'm going to sneak my motorcycle infantry across. Take out my artillery. Back my Panzer off. Send my cavalry over. Sharp shoots in. Use my Azules. Use my Panzer One. Up in there behind him. Okay, I'm just going to use my Stuka to weaken him. Use my JU-88 on these Truppen. Back, use my grenadiers to finish them. Get my command tank up to snuff. Get my 88 in position because that's going to be useful attacking that fortress. And get my bunker buster. So irritating. Okay, so the main guy we have to get rid of now is this guy, and then they are defenseless, basically. Okay, it's going to do it for this turn. Okay, Pioneers, gonna get him right there. Buster, KV-2 up. Shell them from a long distance. Gonna get to my Panzer 1. Hey, some experience. And I'm gonna try to finish this guy off from behind. Oh, I can't fucking get him in there, can I? He's in the deep woods. Alright, this could be a job for my Sturmovik. So he continues to gain experience. Get rid of this minefield here. Shell these troops. Sharfa shoots in. Pioneers forward. Reinforce my Panzer threes. I'm going to use my J88. So that fortress is down to a strength of 16, which is still pretty damn extensive. Other Stuka. Didn't really do anything. Interesting. Okay. That fortress continues to give me problems. Sharpshooters are kind of useless against fortresses. Better. Eights are better. And guess what? Fallschirmjägers are good. Okay. Strength is down to 5. Stuka him down to 2 or 3. Hate him. He's down to 1. And I'm going to use my Pioneer. Finish him off. Okay. Alright, so I just need to take these last two objectives, which I can do, but I'm going to wait, because it says I have to take it before, take up Utrecht a full turn before the last victory hits, okay? In fact, we're going to go with 2 full turns. I can generally excuse the interruption, but I believe there's a matter of some interest that deserves your attention. It seems that some prototype multi-turret tanks were deployed in the ongoing campaign in Norway, but their performance seems to have been rather disappointing. Despite possessing considerable firepower, the tanks were found to be too vulnerable to enemy fire. I bring this to your attention because the vehicles are apparently on their way to the scrapyard. If you would prefer to get these Nuberfrofzung transferred to your command instead, I am certain this can be arranged. It will be too late for them to assist in the battle, but we will have them to keep for future actions. You have 6 commendation points, which I'd like to exchange for points for this unique unit. Sure. Let's try it. Let's go one more turn. Now let's take the last 2 objectives. And that's the end. New development coming in hot. Mine general, stand by. See your telephone receiver. I understand the bombers were a bluff, but they were also fully armed. The reaction Dutch person, thank you. I'll pass on immediately. I'll be saying, well, my general, it seems our battle against the Dutch is at an end. The high command has made an attempt to force the Dutch to capitulate, and it seems they have succeeded. Apparently, they threatened to bomb Rotterdam into submission, and when the negotiations stalled, they followed through on their threat. Because our efforts have so thoroughly dismantled the Dutch air force, our enemies can offer no resistance to such attacks, and the Dutch have totally capitulated. I suppose we were lucky that such an attack didn't merely harden the resolve of our enemies, but I wonder what price Germany might have end up paying for such brazen attacks. With hostilities here at a sudden end, we're due for immediate redeployment. Our attacks against the Dutch and Belgians have lured French and British reinforcements into the Low Countries, and efforts are already underway to isolate and destroy as many of these enemy divisions as we can. But High Command has lost contact with one of the leading Panzer divisions, and they want us to find out what happened to them by attempting to reestablish contact with 7th Panzer Division. The train sending our forces to France should be here in a matter of hours, so I best get the men ready for transit. Historically, the bombing of Rotterdam brought a sudden and dramatic end to the fighting in the Netherlands, although initial casualty estimates were grossly over-exaggerated for purposes. purposes of propaganda. The mere ordering of such attacks set a dark and dangerous precedent. A precedent that the Allied powers would later utilize in full when retaliating against Germany. Okay, that's the end of the debriefing. That's the end of the Battle of Grebebberg. We'll be back next time on another edition of Panzer Corps 2 with Mike. What we're going to do now is go back to the branch. We're going to attack Belgium and go through Belgium. I was going to say Heinrich split his forces into two different forces. All right, see you then.